Hello friends, welcome back to MUST-TACH. I'm Ashish Bharati, MuleSoft Architect. In this session, we are going to discuss about the MuleSoft application deployment using Mule Maven plugin. And inside that, we'll use encrypted passwords. Okay, so generally we use username and password, right? Any one platform credentials inside our configuration tags. So now we'll try to use the encrypted password over there. Okay. So to use encrypted credentials while deploying, we need to set up our Maven master encrypted password. Okay, so for that we need this one, Maven master password. Then we need a file called settingsecurity.xml where to create. I'll show you that one. And then we need a setting.xml also. Okay, so let's jump on to the demo part. So I'll show you how to create these files and what information we need to add it in these two files. Okay, let's jump on to the demo. So first you need to go to your Discord. You need to go to your user directory. Inside that .m2 directory. Okay, this is a local Maven repository. Okay. Inside that, create two empty files, setting.xml and settings.hyphensecurity.xml. Okay. And in these two files, let me open these two files. I'll try to open these two files and I'll show you the content of these two. Okay. So first in settings-security.xml, we need to add this settings security tag and master tag. We'll add the value master password value here. Okay, the encrypted master password value here. Then settings.xml, we need to create settings tag. Inside that servers, and inside servers we need to give our AnyPoint platform credentials. Okay, so this is my username, password, encrypted password, we'll add it here. Okay, so this is the first step. We need to create two empty files, and then in these two empty files we need to add the data in this structure. Okay, so this is the first step. Now let's go to the second step where we'll create the encrypted password. So let me start the command prompt. And to generate this encrypted password, we'll be using Maven commands. Okay, so let me go to command prompt and I'll try to run the command. So first, we'll create a master password. Okay, encrypted master password. So how to do that? So you can use this command mvn space hyphen hyphen encrypt, okay, hyphen master hyphen password. Okay, and now you give a plain text your master password. So I will say here mule1234 is my master password. Okay, so let's generate this encrypted value. Now you can copy this value, okay, and go to your settings-security. Okay, be careful when you are copying these values. So here inside this master tag, you need to copy that value. Make sure there is no space in front, at the end, no space. Okay, make sure that. Save this file. Okay, now your master password is stored in this file, settings security.xml. Now let's go and create an encrypted password for your AnyPoint platform credentials. Okay, again I'll go back to my command prompt. Okay, and here I'll say instead of master, now I'll remove that master. Okay, and now I'll type my encrypt and give it this. I'll try to anyway, I'll change this password. Don't worry about it. Okay, so we'll generate the, now this is the encrypted value of your AnyPoint platform password. Okay, now copy and paste this values in setting.xml. Make sure there are no spaces in front and at the end. Okay, this is the second step. So we have created two XML files, and inside these XML files, we have added the proper content. Now this ID you need to be, you need to remember this, okay? Or because we need this inside our form.xml. So let's go ahead. Step number one, go to the .m2 directory, create two files. Then inside those files, we need to add proper content. That till now we have done, okay? Now let's go to the, I have created simple app. Okay, I'll show you the simple app. So it is a Hello World app, okay? Inside that, go to the form.xml. Inside the build tag plugins, plugin, go to the Mule Maven plugin. And then inside that, add the configuration tag, okay? And this, you don't need to mug up again. You can find it this, you know, on MuleSoft documentation. So now what I wanted to add, this server, this is the tag, and this is the reference coming from the setting.xml. This is what we have in C, setting.xml, this ID. Okay, so this AnyPoint platform credentials are getting referred by this ID inside my form.xml. If I go to my form.xml now, this is what. So I don't need to add anything here, you know, regarding my AnyPoint platform credentials. Now you need to add Mule version, then application name, your environment, sandbox, how many workers, worker type, and object. Okay, that's it. Now let's go back to the project root directory. So I'll go here, go to properties, to the location, and then we need to run the command prompt from here. And fire a command, maven, clean the, you know, whatever artifact generated because of previous build, then package it, and then deploy it, minus D, mule, deploy, okay? So now run this command. Before that, let's log into our AnyPoint platform and see, is there anything in the runtime manager? There is nothing right now, runtime manager. Let's wait for the deployment. Let's see what's happening. So meanwhile, I'll recap what we have done, okay? So I'll go back from the form.xml. So inside the form.xml, this is common. Inside of, I know, instead of my AnyPoint platform credentials, instead of passing those credentials here, I have created a file called setting.xml. And inside the setting.xml, I have given the placeholder, okay, server placeholder, with this AnyPoint platform credentials. Now, this password I have encrypted. And to encrypt this password, I have created master password. And that master password I have stored in this file, setting security.xml. And we have created these two files inside .m2 directory. You can find both the files over here in the .m2 directory, setting.xml and settings-security.xml. That's it. Now let's wait. Yes, it's getting deployed. Okay, I'll pause the video till this get deployed. Now our app is deployed and started. Let's test it. Okay. So if I go here and if I trigger it, yes, we are able to see the proper output from the app. Okay. That's it from this session. Hope you liked it. Please hit the like button, hit the bell icon so that you'll get, you know, notification for new coming videos. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.